a chair for her. Turn on the air for her and just cool out, cool out.
Hey, yo, it's a Red Hood crime saga. The names was changed to protect the guilty. Yeah, shorty was used to being jiggy, but then he fell off and did a bit for spanking this kid up in the city. Sitting pretty, pimping the act and kept a stack on him. Pulled over one night and his man stashed cracks on him. See, he was wanted and his fam started flipping on him. His mom was on it cause the law put a whipping on him. Shorty was feared and respected, known for slapping it's a stripping to make him walk around the projects butt naked. It remind me of the good fellas, but deep down the snake mans wanted to knock him off cause they was jealous. They made a deal and got him back style. He got the manslaughter cause he knew he would've blew the trial. He's a scheming all along and got acquitted on him. His girl and his man broke in the safe and they shitted on him. And now they living the fast life and he's hitting that ass, right? And got a hook to the glass pipe. The game never changed, only the players. Well, some in heaven castles and thrones, some end up deathbed layers. Victims of the system stripped mentally. Hit with 25 to life or the death penalty. The game never changed, only the players. Well, some in heaven castles and thrones, some end up deathbed layers. Victims of the system is stripped mentally. Hit with 25 to life or the death penalty. 6 months without a visit, now he's getting worried. Up north scraping and yanking it's for their commissary. Been down for 5, came home and still wanted that dead. Got on his feet and put rewards out on that head. Running 2 spots, it's hot so he fled out of state. Cause he's out on parole and his PO's dying to violate. His rule is narrow, he's parole cause he's on the run. Walking in the building with his back against the door holding his gun. Running the pipe ready to spank something. Cutting grams with his man holding the blade ready to shank something. See, now he's getting major money. Throwing bricks and then in his clique started acting funny. He started sniffing, getting off his own supply. Shorty was slipping and his about to die. Pimped his workers with high heels and a skirt. Now they scheming to put his 10% in dirt. The game never changed, only the players. While some inherit castles and thrones, some end up deathbed layers. Victims of the system is stripped mentally. Hit with 25 to life or the death penalty. The game never changed, only the players. While some inherit castles and thrones, some end up deathbed layers. Victims of the system is stripped mentally. Hit with 25 to life or the death penalty. He worked his way up from grinding and scraping hand to hand on the block and slinging rocks on consignment. He got plugged and now he's juggling bricks and moving weight and bubbling gas and traffic and big ace out of the state. Faked his death and ducked the feds, but little did he know that his ex had put a price out on his head. One night she plugged him to a pickup, she's supposed to pick a brick up. She led him right into a stick up. His wheel was spinning fast, the walls of hell were closing. An angel of death was on it. His adversaries rose again. 100 grand in the trunk to cop the crystal. He was sleep. That in the back seat had packed the. He put and twist his wig backwards. Yanked the suitcase out the trunk. Snake left him slump over the wheel with his wig peeled. Brains on the dashboard and blood all on the windshield. I watched him lay on his deathbed with a swollen head. Waited for his heart to stop cause he was brain dead. Angel of death was waiting by his bedside. He jerked his arm the next morning and then a tear ran down his left eye. 6 men carried his coffin, put him 6 feet in the ground while I stood 6 feet over in a black suit looking down. Thinking, why was I chosen to survive and bear these memories? That dirty game, death is always the penalty.
Rest in peace, my brother Ra, Bumpy, Junior, Herb, you know what I'm saying? Just, Jeff Frey, my man Steve-O, they always shot in the head.
Never change, only the players. While some inherit castles and thrones, some end up deathbed layers. Victims of the system is stripped mentally. Hit with 25 to life or the death penalty. The game never change, only the players. While some inherit castles and thrones, some end up deathbed layers. Victims of the system stripped mentally. Hit with 25 to life or the death penalty.
Hey, yo, it's a Red Hood crime saga. The names was changed to protect the guilty. Yeah, shorty was used to being jiggy, but then he fell off and did a bit for spanking this kid up in the city. Sitting pretty, pimping the act and kept a stack on him. Pulled over one night and his man stashed cracks on him. See, he was wanted and his fam started flipping on him. His mom was on it cause the law put a whipping on him. Shorty was feared and respected, known for slapping it's a stripping to make him walk around the projects butt naked. It remind me of the good fellas, but deep down the snake mans wanted to knock him off cause they was jealous. They made a deal and got him back style. He got the manslaughter cause he knew he would've blew the trial. He's a scheming all along and got acquitted on him. His girl and his man broke in the safe and they shitted on him. And now they living the fast life and he's hitting that ass, right? And got a hook to the glass pipe. The game never changed, only the players. Well, some inherit throne, some end up deathbed layers. Victims of the system stripped mentally. Hit with 25 to life or the death penalty. The game never changed, only the players. While some inherit castles and thrones, some end up deathbed layers. Victims of the system and stripped mentally. Hit with 25 to life or the death penalty. 6 months without a visit, now he's getting worried. Up north scraping and yanking for their commissary. Been down for 5, came home and still wanted that dead. Got on his feet and put rewards out on that head. Running 2 spots, it's hot, so he fled out of state. Cause he's out on parole and his PO's dying to violate. His rule is narrow, he's barrel cause he's on the run. Walking in the building with his back against the door, holding his gun. Running the pipe ready to spank something. Cutting grams with his man, holding the blade ready to shank something. See, now he's getting major money. Throwing bricks and then in his clique started acting funny. He started sniffing, getting off his own supply. Shorty was slipping and his about to die. Pimped his workers with high heels and a skirt. Now they scheming to put his 10% in dirt. The game never changed, only the players. While some inherit castles and thrones, some end up deathbed layers. Victims of the system and stripped mentally. Hit with 25 to life or the death penalty. The game never changed, only the players. While some inherit castles and thrones, some end up deathbed layers. Victims of the system and stripped mentally. Hit with 25 to life or the death penalty. He worked his way up from grinding and scraping hand to hand on the block and slinging rocks on consignment. He got plugged and now he's juggling bricks and moving weight and bubbling gas and traffic and big ace out of the state. Faked his death and ducked the feds, but little did he know that his ex had put a price out on his head. One night she plugged him to a pickup. She's supposed to pick a brick up. She led him right into a stick up. His wheel was spinning fast, the walls ahead were closing. An angel of death was on it. His adversary rose again. 100 grand in the trunk to cop the crystal. He was sleep. That in the back seat had packed the. He put and twist his wig backwards. Yanked the suitcase out the trunk. Snake left him slump over the wheel with his wig peeled. Brains on the dashboard and blood all on the windshield. I watched him lay on his deathbed with a swollen head. Waited for his heart to stop cause he was brain dead. Angel of death was waiting by his bedside. He jerked his arm the next morning and then a tear ran down his left eye. 6 men carried his coffin, put him 6 feet in the ground. While I stood 6 feet over in a black suit looking down. Thinking why was I chose to survive and bear these memories. That dirty game, death is always the penalty.
Yo, rest in peace my brother Ra, Bumpy, Junior, Herb, you know what I'm saying, Just, Jeff Frey, my man Steve-O, they always shot in the head.
The game never changed, only the players. While some inherit castles and thrones, some end up deathbed layers. Victims of the system is stripped mentally. Hit with 25 to life or the death penalty. The game never changed, only the players. While some inherit castles and thrones, some end up deathbed layers. Victims of the system stripped mentally. Hit with 25 to life or the death penalty.
And we's back in here, man. B-side show every single Monday night doing the damn thing. Live shit with the dopest artists coming through. And you know what's even doper? When we got cats that are in town that, you know, make it a priority to stop through our spot, man. We really do appreciate that, bro. And you've been doing your thing. Go ahead and introduce yourself for the peeps, man.
Shabazz the Disciple, wings up. I ain't got no voice. Working hard. Contra got me working hard out here, so
yeah,
Jeremy, you working, man.
I like that though, man. Working with Contra Crew and all that,
it's
man.
My brothers, man. You know, familia.
You know you're gonna work when you're going with them. That's the thing, man. That's dope. Hey, so what you guys just get back from doing? You know what you guys working on? Let them know.
We did a show in Ontario, which was supposed to have been in Los Angeles, but the Most High, he's so beautiful, he had to play chess real quick and get rid of the demons so we can come here, White Feather.
That's right. Hey, shout out to the Unity Project as well, man. I believe they were throwing that show and everything like that. Hey, man, so what's been in the works, man? You've been moving around, but you're about to head back. But while you've been here, what's been happening, man?
We did Bakersfield, San Jose, Ontario, L.A. We were supposed to do San Diego, but the Most High didn't want that to happen. Me and Jerm got some good footage yesterday instead. And we here today on B-Sides, baby. B-SidesShow.net.
Yeah. Thank you. Right. Thank you, man, for doing that. As far as music, though, let the people know. I mean, you know, they you make sure if you don't already have any of the catalog. This dude got a catalog right here, which we'll get to in a second. But what you've been working on currently as far as your music, man?
I got like 100 albums.
Right.
I've been recording
right.
since I was in my mother's stomach. I was doing pull-ups on her rib cage. Her heartbeat was a boom bap.
Oh, that's right.
I was freestyling in the womb. So I've been recording my album since then. I don't never stop. Whenever I put it out, that's your album.
Yeah.
And happy birthday to the Book of Shabazz, because it just turned, I think, 15.
Wow.
I was on a flight, and it turned 15. The flight could come in here.
Hey, and that's the one, yeah, and that's the thing, like, people have that, like, that's classic material, bro, and the thing is, that's what I was going to ask you originally, you know, coming in with the group and doing your thing and all that, when you, like, what was the steps in deciding to go solo and doing your own thing?
I was always solo.
Oh, okay.
Before I met RZA.
Okay.
I was doing my own videos. Putting them on TV. I was on the radio. I was doing shows, breaking the mic, kicking a hole in the speaker.
Pull the plug.
Rakim said that.
Yeah,
so I got chased out of the clubs. I tried that shit though. But the journey was beautiful. Cause it was all Brooklyn. We all had Timberland steel toes on, ready for the war. But my cousin Freestyle from The Arsonist, shout out to you, boy. Could never repay you. He played my demo for RZA, 1992. His manager brought him over there. Because Freestyle, he was rolling with the Translator crew, who y'all know as the Fugees.
He was going to be the
fourth.
Yeah, yeah.
He was going to be the fourth member of that group. His manager was managing him and the Fugees, so he always had them together. Shout out to Flipper. He was the best dancer in New York. Dances was popping in the 80s. So he was bringing Freestyle around to different producers to get production for his demo. One of the houses he went to was RZA's. So he played his demo. It was reggae, though. So RZA was like, nah, we don't really deal with reggae. You know what I'm saying? Your shit is hot, though. I can make hip-hop shit for you. He's like, I got somebody you're going to love. He pulled out my demo. He played it. Raekwon, all of them. Deck, all of them. He said they all came in the room. Yo, who that? Yo, who the fuck is that? Yo, that nigga crazy. So, nigga, RZA called me. Yeah, I am.
It's a rap, man. Hey, but that's usually what it boils down to when they get someone like when other cats coming in the room going, "What the fuck? Who's that, man?"
That made like, RZA didn't even need to hear no more probably. Cause if it was me, I'd be like, "It's a rap." Co-signed by the family, is a go.
Yeah, that's right. So in the meantime, man, and you know, let them know the hometown for also. By the way, man.
I'm from Red Hook Projects, man. Yup. Come on, man. It's a Red Hook crime saga. The names was changed to protect the guilty. So, you know, when you hear me saying names on songs, that ain't the real names.
Thank you for clearing that. Thank you for clearing that up, man. Hey, no, but along the way, man, I know, man, you got to have a lot of, like, up-and-coming MCs and stuff like that are like, man, bro.
I fucks with Contra in them right now because... I mean, let me explain something to y'all. These are like my spiritual twin brothers because they come with the CIA made up the name conspiracy theorists to discredit the prophets.
To discredit
the ones who tell you it before it happened. The warners, the seers. I bring it through the scriptures to make you understand them from a different perspective. We both saying the same thing. I'm just using it through the scriptures. I filter everything through the Bible. Because the Red Hook Projects is like Bethlehem. Like, you know, Queensbridge is Nazareth. When you read the scriptures, it's the same story. Same story. So it prepares you how to face what you're facing now. The Romans was the centurions. That's the LAPD.
Yeah, right.
It makes sense. So I'm making it simple as I can through the scriptures to prove to you. But they doing it through all of the conspiracy theories, which all come true. So what's the theory about?
Hey, how'd you guys originally link up, man? How'd you guys?
I was out here in 2011 doing felony fights, Cage vs. Cards.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
At the LA Sports Arena with felony fights, Sick Fuck Danny and them Cage vs. Cards. And It's deep, because I don't even remember the first time we really, really met. That's deep. But all I know is I feel like I've been new to. We met before.
That's
we did this before.
Yeah, that's
we came back to finish.
Finish what you started, man.
It don't even matter when we met. We fucking finished now.
That's right, man.
Conspiracy theory. Because
I can put a date on it, but it was 3,000 years ago. I don't even remember that shit. Because when you go up, he erased your memory.
See,
there you go.
Journey said, yeah, he remembers. Hey, man, thank you for coming through, by the way. We appreciate that shit, man. But a lot of solid music out there. For those that don't know, can you let them know some of the catalog, man? We talked about a little of it, but let them know.
The first was Diary of a Madman on the Grave Diggers. Then after that, it was Death Be the Penalty. Fourth Disciple, Five Archangels, Sons of Man, which me and Killer Priest was a group, Disciples of Armageddon, and Hellraiser was always with me. That was my little brother. Prodigal was always with him. So when me and Killer Priest was doing our album, we featured them on two songs. Hold up, that's a whole new group right there we just gave birth to. So we created that so all of our brothers could be on the stage hugged up with us instead of just me and Killer Priest, because we already was hot from Diary. So I wanted my brothers up there, too, to get them a slot. That's it. That's all it is. You just look out and add on. It's about the brotherhood.
And I think that's kind of lost nowadays most of the time, bro. I mean, it still happens in certain fams or whatever, but I think that's kind of lost. Like, everybody's, like, feeling like if I put someone on, they're going to take away from my shine. But
that's insecurity.
Right? Thank you. He just said it right
there. You're insecure,
there.
Man.
Yeah, yeah.
You got to be confident in what you're doing and know you're going to get there regardless. Help some people, man. When you look down at them, help them up. Don't look down at them like that. Help them up. Because when he get up and you down, he might help you up.
Yeah, that's right.
And man, we keep up. We stay up. Wings up.
That's right. So you've been in the game for many years, you know, speaking the truth. What do you think is the biggest difference from back in, you know, the 90s to now?
Mumbleclod. That mumble shit, mumble clod, hip hop, wapping. The fuck is going on? Yeah.
Well, exactly. But
they dumbed it down. Listen, in Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 4, it says the daughters of music will be brought low. That means the creativity level will be shit. Tell me that ain't a conspiracy theory. For your ass.
Hey, thank you. Hey,
written by King Solomon.
We have
the wisest
shows,
king ever.
We have one of them shows where you're going to get some knowledge today, man. You're going to learn. You know what I'm saying?
Get up.
Yeah, right?
Shout out to my man in there who just played that beat. We going to get back to that after these messages.
Oh, yeah, yeah. What up, Big Gene, man? Part of the fam right here on the show, man. Hey, this is what we're going to do, play a quick video. We'll be back. We got a couple more things to talk about in the end of the show. Whoever wants to, you know,
shout out to everybody in Cali that be showing love, man. Not the LAPD, though.
Yeah, not them. Shabazz the Disciple in the building, man. We'll be right back.
Dodgers. Dodgers. Get it on. Get it on. 4-3, baby. 4-3. I'm calling it. Ready to get it on whenever, wherever we with it. After we hit it and we did it, each other we split it.
Take control. I'm making dope, but not enough to blow. J.O.'s, they lost my flow, but they yo. I don't trust the song.
Before this court passes judgment, will the four defendants please rise and approach the bench?
Trust me, guys, it's all under control. The judge is my uncle. He'll take the insanity plea. Oh, yeah, don't forget my retainer balance.
Okay, I understand you guys are pleading insanity, claiming demonic spirits possess you to do these hideous murders. Can you please explain to this court how these so-called spirits made you into these raving madmen?
Bear witness as I exercise my exorcism. The evil that lurks within, the sin, the terrorism. Possessed by evil spirits, voices from the dead. I come forth with grave diggers in a head full of dread. I've been examined ever since I was semen. They took a sonogram and seen the image of a demon. At birth, nurses surrounded me with needles and drug me all up with the diseases of evil. Grew up in hell, now I dwell in an Islamic temple. I'm fighting a holy war in the mental. Look deep in my eyes, you see visions of death. Possessed by homicide is what I am obsessed. Giving niggas brain dimples. Dragging their asses on my hook by their temples. The cause of death is unknown to the cops. Cause when I kill them, I'm not leaving one element, two or tops. First I'll assassinate him, and then I cremate him. Then take all of his fucking ashes and evaporate him. Or creep through the graveyard and hunt down your tombstone. Dig up your skeleton and stomp all your fucking bones. You try to haunt me, nigga, I ain't trying to hear it. Buck, 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 I give your ass a Holy Spirit.
Explain to this court when these problems first began.
The year 84, November, day 10. Overwhelmed by the wicked inspirations of an evil djinn. I realized my ideas has spawned for 400 years of blood, sweat, and tears. I saw the torture, brutal murder of my father. So my brain became stained with the horror. I'm having reoccurring nightmares of being soaking wet, strapped down to the electric chair. I got tackled with handcuffs and shackles and restraint in the bottom of a holy tabernacle. They gave me nothing to eat for 2 weeks and sold my eyelids open so I couldn't sleep. About to die from thirst, that's when the minister quenched my jaws with a cold glass of vinegar. Upon my wounds, they seasoned me with salt and knelt my hands and feet to the form of a cross. Ah, I cried as the blood dripped inside of my eye, refusing to die. Visions of hell tormented my fate, so I chewed my fucking arm off and made an escape.
Calm down, people. Please calm down. Let us please proceed with the defendant's explanation.
Into the realms of understanding, and take good heed, or you could bleed while I'm scanning. Three stages of pure hell, 60 cages of red cells. Shh, raindrops hiss the pales. Path is dull and narrow. You stalk by a shadow. I pierce your skull with a fucking arrow. So narrow, only one could enter at a time. Stuck in the center, read the signs. A thousand doors to choose. You better hurry, don't stop. Shit is getting hot as a pot of curry. On your right side, there's fire. Your left, deep waters. Watch your step, there's deep waters. What's that coming through the floor? Is a claw. Psh, took his fucking ass to the fucking core.
Stroll through the dark conditions. I stone you till I see sparks and frictions. I chop you like a coal miner. Then combine the drug and mix it with your blood. Some more, I give you some more and watch you crawl. Guts hit the floor, worms exit your pores. I trick you, ha, then I'm quick to syringe. Deep between my thoughts that bust out your skin. You scream, portraits of inflictable pain. You can't stand, you're up to your hands in quicksand. You're sinking and sinking deep into the earth. Thoughts was possessed since the first day of birth. My mental says, it's my turn to possess the matter. Stab you with a dagger up Jacob's ladder. Thoughts become shattered, confused and tragic. Fiery thoughts of grave diggers.
Guilty. Next case.
We're back in here, man. We're even having a good time off air, you know, in the middle, playing some joints, man. And we played some, you know, like some Pun was bumping in the back. Hey, man. For those that don't know, can you kind of speak on that, man? You know a little bit about some Big Pun, man. But can
that's my brother, man.
That's
like,
right.
Like in hip hop, you know, you get influenced by some people. They pass the torch, and sometimes it's not a good torch because they go somewhere else with it in Mumba Clot or something. But Pun, when I met him, he said, "Yo, I got my style from Crime Saga. I love you. Me, you, and Killer Priest got to do a song." On my album, he was doing his first album on Capital Punishment. And he said, let's call it Let Him Have It. I was going to Europe. He moved to Miami with Fat Joe. So schedule conflicts, I didn't make the album. Then he died, so, but I love him. And I love, he used to big me up every day on the radio. He used to tell the same, he say the same thing I'm saying.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, get in touch with Cuban Link. He'll tell you the same thing because he was standing there.
That's right, man. That and that's that real, like, that's part of, you know what I'm saying, hip-hop history.
Yeah, some dudes will just take your shit and run.
Yeah.
He told me, like, yo, you influenced me. So, same thing I told Rakim and Slick Rick. You know, I give it up to my torch passers.
Hey, that's dope you said. I got to, you know, the honor of hosting a Rakim show.
Dope.
Yeah, man, Universal City, bro. And you know, growing up bumping his shit, I can still do most of his songs hip-hop karaoke
to
style.
To this day. You know, and you know every word right? Before you knew your ABCs.
Right.
Yeah.
To host a show with the homie was so dope. And then it was crazy because then I seen it's not just me. And, you know, I know hip-hop is universal and all that, but I seen, like, Jill Scott was on the stage because she was a fan of Rakim. She just wanted to go out there and vibe. And then Razzcast, the homie Razzcast, was there. And these dudes, like, just soaking it up as fans. And that just leads me to, like, kind of what you were talking about, bro, is, like, it comes back to that time where people, when you know someone's dope, give that respect back instead of, you know what I mean? You don't need to hold that.
Speaking of Rakim, I remember the first time I got to do a tour with him, Grave Diggers. We did MTV Rakim Rink. We was in Sweden, right? It was like 150,000 people. It was retarded, right? So this is when I knew I was on to something. When I came out and did Bear Witness, the whole fucking ocean of people said Bear Witness. That shit pushed me backwards. That was the first moment I realized I was on the show.
Was
accepted.
Did you tell the DJ run it back?
Pulo.
Hey, all right.
Nice. Yeah, Pulo. All right.
That's right, man.
But listen, shout out to C1, Rum Saga, know what I'm saying? Mike Justice, Contra, Jeremy Germ on the camera, B-Side Show. Let me explain something, right? See this t-shirt? You see this hoodie?
Yeah.
The Klein Syndicate. This was going to be a movie we shot, but it's too much content. So it's going to be a series, a TV series.
Wow.
So we turning down Hollywood and all of them. We're going to do it ourselves because we want to keep it raw, like no cut, no bacon soda. But the sound, I'm covering the soundtrack. I'm controlling that. But I'm pulling in kids from everywhere. They sent their music from Atlanta, Philly, Jersey, fire, the young youth, R&B and hip-hop, but it gotta make sense to the crack era, like, you understand, and yeah. I'm picking all of the songs that fit, but to be honest, ever since y'all heard me till now, I've been telling y'all this story, this the soundtrack to this story, Crime Saga, Organized Rhyme, when I say, this one goes out to all my family doing fed time. My Uncle Cliff, Supreme Hardhead, and Godfather Klein. I was already bigging them up when they was doing life in the feds, 25 to life in the feds. They did their time, now they home. So now, we getting it on. We turning it up with the movies and the films. And I'm gonna try to get Germ on that project also.
That's right, man. I was chopping it up.
Director, right?
Yeah, I was chopping it up brother. With him off air. But you're also in the works with that. There's a documentary that's been going on. You want to speak on that a little
that's
bit?
That's with me and Germ. I got one actually on the East Coast also.
Okay.
But the one me and Germ, we've been started it since 2011 when Cage vs. Khan's time and felony fights at the arena.
That was a
that's
big
when
event.
I met him. Yeah. And we just locked. Like, when I met them, we just locked. It was, I met them both the same time. Locked. Like, we was meant to link up. God did that. So, the documentary, he came to Red Hook. Like, he flew out to Philly to a family reunion, rented a car. After the family, you know, take care of the family, I'm going to Red Hook. He came and got me. We went to Red Hook. We filming. He had a little bit of the experience of Red Hook. And the Fontes. But the footage he got, we already had footage out here because we went on a tour with Grind Time to San Jose, San Francisco, Rock the Bells, like that. After I did San Bernardino Rock the Bells, they asked me, Grind Time asked me, gave me an hour on their stage at
that's dope.
The next one. So we rolled out. He was filming. We got a lot of that documented. He just been filming. And we just been adding on. He sent me the edit. It's done. But I said, I'm coming back. He's like, no, let's get more. The more, the better. And I agree. So the name of that, The Prophet Sees. The Prophet Sees. Hey. But The Prophet Sees. I see it before it happened. I tell you.
That's fucking
I warn you. Now, if everybody's saying I'm crazy, 12 years ago I told them the chip is coming, martial law is coming, World War III is coming, but it wasn't on the news or in the textbook. They didn't believe me. Crazy. Put him in a hospital. I got it from the Bible. That book was written 3,000 years ago. They were saying the same thing I'm saying right now. Imagine if I'm crazy now and it's on the news, what the hell was they to them same mumble clods?
And you know what's crazy is how all that shit ties in, like, no matter how far things go along, like, that's that real shit right there, man.
For those who don't really click and understand it,
right,
from a scriptural point, then you got Contra.
Yeah, yeah. They'll give you
You're
the
gonna
research.
Get this work, baby. Double-edged sword. You're gonna get this work. Ain't gonna be no excuse.
You're gonna understand. You're gonna think for yourself. Stop listening to what everybody.
I just posted a post earlier. They said, "Oh, the Metro Card, which how you get on the train and the bus in New York, it's done. You got to use your iPhone." People like, we can't. Everybody can't afford an iPhone. Well, you're a terrorist. You got to swipe your phone to get on the bus and the train.
Damn.
They getting you ready. Oh, we do that anyway. Son, I do that with a Metro card with $1,000 on it.
See what?
You're gonna have to swipe your hand. They getting you they predictive programming. They programming you.
They want us barcodes on the necks, man. Hey man, thank you for
kicking
that knowledge, brother.
Me and my man Rum Saga, Rum Saga, Dio, and my nigga C1. We're going to give you that work, too. We're going to go in the studio before I fly out, all
okay.
right? We're going to lay one of those bangers down. We're going to bag up some cocaina.
Hey, my man Gio, man, my man Gio knows his hip-hop,
trust me,
man.
Son.
He going to give you that
record. Yo, you know what's crazy? I met him in the sports arena that night when I met all of them. So this shit is crazy. How it's all,
like you said, it's meant to be. Yeah,
it's meant to be.
Exactly, bro. Thank you for coming through. This is what we're going to do, man.
Ha.
Play something real quick, and we're going to come back. Let some people. Who wants to rap? We're going to let it go like that, man. I'm going to end the show like
that. I would.
Yeah.
I might just lose my voice again, man.
Hey, you might be feeling
I'm trying to save it for the studio, man.
Super Drew on the ones and twos, man. We'll be right back
after
this.
Ain't no excuse. You throw that heat on, I'm in that ass.
DJ Super Drew on the ones and twos.
We got something going on tomorrow, man. Let me get you a mic, bro. We'll find you a mic. Yeah, there we go.
I still cupped the mic, too. Look at
that. Yeah. Hey, man. But we got something going on. I mean, this is fam right here, man. And you guys been doing your thing at Katie Jake's every Tuesday.
Yes,
talk about it real quick, man.
Let them talk about it. I'm going to talk about it. No, yeah, we've been doing Tuesday nights since, like, pretty much the beginning of the year at Katie Jake's and Neighborhood Watch Promotions. And we've been doing real good, man. We've been getting a big swing of new faces, and we've been bringing new promotion, like, homies to come in and help out, show what they got, and the B-side's been really helping us out.
And you guys been getting cats from, like, fucking overseas, you know what I'm saying, East Coast. Like, you've been getting a lot of dope performers there.
It's pretty much been like a product of our hustle and our work, man. Like, we've been getting hit up by people, just making connections and not closing the door too fast on anyone that got an idea. And it's been working out. Underground's been really forming together like Voltron over here in on the east side of
our
LA
neighbors, man. Katie Jake's right here in Covina. You know, we're at 130 Shoppers Lane in Covina. I don't know offhand. It's Torado Plaza, but it's right, like, literally right next door to us, man.
It's
but
Katie Jake's.
Our neighbors, Katie Jake's.
Everyone got a smartphone. If you can't remember that and put it in, then shut the fuck up.
Yeah. Hey, but
tomorrow night,
Vel the Wonder
Tuesday
live.
Night.
We got who else? Tightly Sealed. Who
look
else?
At it, look there? At this. I'm so prepared. Look
oh,
at
look.
This.
There you go.
My favorite Chicana con hambre is going to be there.
Oh, yeah, tacos. Shit.
Those malitas. Oh, my fucking Lord. Right. Where's the fat people at?
Yeah, yeah.
They're gonna go to Jack in the Box right now. Show up tomorrow.
I'm a fat person in a skinny person's body, but I'll be there eating
my
tacos tomorrow.
Tomorrow,
October, what month is this? What year
October,
is this?
October. Yeah.
October 16th, we got Vel the Wonder.
Yeah.
We got VHS, Don't Sleep, Tightly Sealed, I Am Lyrics. If you haven't seen I Am Lyrics, motherfuckers,
oh,
better be prepared.
Dope, bro. Yeah.
Crop Circles, hell yeah, OGs. Yeah. And Hypeson, man, we're going to do real good. And we got, I think, Clover's spinning.
Hattie Clover.
And I can't think of his name.
Hey,
right,
we
here.
Know some dude named Roz also that
Roz
might be
Remedy's
there.
Roz
Remedy's
a house DJ, man. We got Splice.
He better
we
be there.
We also got a couple others that we really fuck with. And
right.
It's going to be a good night.
$5. Is Splice going to be there too?
Splice is always there. Even if he's not
homie?
There.
Yeah.
Even if he's not, he's there.
I love kicking it with Splice.
$5 ahead and show up early. It may sell out. So
yeah, this tomorrow I think will. So you guys show up early, man. $5 at the door. Make sure you guys get in there. Neighborhood Watch
Besides
presents.
Buying drinks for
yeah
me.
Yeah.
Not you.
Yeah.
I'm joking.
Wait,
maybe
no, you know what? Actually, it might be better to treat everybody to a beer than treat him. This guy could fucking pound, so
yeah,
I don't know.
Exactly. So maybe just show up and we'll find out.
He said exactly. Hey, make sure you guys go. Neighborhood Watch presents along with B-Side Show Vel the Wonder live in Covina at Katie Jake's this
week. Yeah. Thank you, B-Side. Hey, make sure you always tune in to B-Side.
Yes.
Or else I'm going to kick you on your B-Side.
Yeah, yeah. In your
B-Side Show
yeah.
every Monday night, 9 p.m. You guys don't forget, I have Fridays, October 19th, this Friday, coming up at Project Mayhem. 2669
Patty Clover will be spinning there too.
Patty Clover will be there opening up the night, which is going to be amazing. I'm really excited. I have Bad Habit Creations is going to be there as well. I wanted to bring all the strong-minded women together to represent and bring awareness and, you know, bring a comfortable environment for you guys. Bring whoever you want. Bring your cousin. Bring your mama. Bring your honey. You know, have some fun and come support me. It's 420 friendly. No cover.
Make sure you guys get out there, man. We support the ladies as well doing their thing, man. That's some real shit. Hey, we're going to get into some shit right now. Shout out to the homie, man, Super Drew on the ones and twos for coming through, you know, getting us through the evening with them live-ass mixes and even off-air playing the dopest cuts. So what we're going to do is play a couple more jams, whoever wants to rock something live. I think the homie Troy has a freestyle about his little pee-pee. Coming up right now.
Hey,
we'll be right back.
Yo, it's the B-Side show.
Check it out.
It's the B-Side show.
I've been paying attention to what's
Super
going on.
Super Drew on the ones and twos, man.
I've been paying attention to what's going on out there, man. I've been paying attention to what's going on out there, man.
Who want the mic? Who want the mic?
I've been paying attention to what's going on out there, man.
Who want the mic tonight? Yo, baby girl, fantasy, holding the tight. Somebody come take it.
Right.
Yeah, 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 check it out, pick up, What up? What up? Yo, yeah. Yo, I claw, rip the rock, direct hit, spit, fireballs of flame, raising sharp teeth, rip the beef with dumb brawls, lame moves, they be chasing capital gain with no main aim. Chalk out lines, getting a race, but no names. Yo, blood stains, lit to the street and streets. We know it's hard, but pain to retain and sustain the place of this game with patience. Cause yeah, my passion is ancient. I got love for African, Latino, and Asian, Caucasian, all types of brothers, Middle East, even. Cause politicians' opinions be deceiving. They point the fingers and automatically we supposed to be believing. But I gotta truly trust. Rock steady styles that they discuss. He comes as loud with a bus. Can a boy be a must? Can't see myself in some cuffs, kid. Yeah, the shit is rough. So I steady rip these. I pull seas of rhymes. I'm about to seize a mind. Hypocrisies be lying with exact misconception and deception that crept in. But I'm straight up by design. I'm a line untamable. Same the for fucking training, yo. The see when they get a god.
The devil
what?
Calls.
What?
The devil
what?
Called up to leave a message.
Yeah.
The mental slave infested.
What?
Mission's objective. The hidden camera stuffed inside the medallion of his necklace. Multiple caliber shell cases. Shooters ambidextrous. Framed as a fraud. Chavez's disciples spit his lyrics and came out sounding like God. Well, it's a blasphemous conspiracy theory, rhyme activist. I go ahead, I freestyle with the flow. Go ahead, get caught in a trap. Go ahead, suspect. B-side show, .net. Mondays at 9 p.m. Go ahead, and if you hit my throat, it's like I spit phlegm. Because guess what? Style is wild. I got hit with a neck by Clydesdale. 200 and 300 miles in San Jose. They didn't play. We went into some shit to the Apple Valley. But they tried to scramble my brain. I don't know, fuck that shit. I won't repair a Jesus' sandals by floating on a skyscraper that hangs from an asteroid. Power using a solar panel. Fire corn, I'm on the clear channel.
So we coming back, in fact, with words that'll smack motherfuckers back to the linoleum. Like it was a B-boy, cause now you know that I'm opening them like fucking the Omen. So check how it is that I'm rolling out, and you know that I'm scrolling it out. So read it up every time that I'm creasing it up, like old school gangbang fucking spotting the creases. So check it out, damn it indeed. Pick up to all my brothers that is deceased with the fucking word of Valley and the Beast. And cause check it out, I'm rocking from west to the east. And check how it is that I'm manifesting only the ones that is mind molesting. So what you be here holding it down? Indeed, you know that's the truth. What M to the fucking E, to the fucking S to the E, to the A. Self fucking enlightenment acknowledged. Now you know that we rockin' hip hop. You know it ain't polished. Just stay gritty and grimy. Off the fucking top of the mind, you know you define me. Every time I'm defining the beat, oh my god, you know I'm fucking sticking it like a killer bee.
Who drops down with the reportment of Martians delivered as a style. First they pack in the rations. The aliens take the form of humans to abduction to a flying saucer transmission.
MCs, where you at? Jump on it!
Through storm panic constellation. Three finger sign language communication. In trilateral insignia formation. Big brothers watching. Surveillance cameras stuffed through the eyes of robotic pigeon. Come on, the martial law sounds a klaxon. The lizard men breathe through gills for ventilation. Come on, the martial law sounds a klaxon. They worship dragons and snakes, Medusa's head on the plate. Lady of a lake, son of the serpent, Alexander the Great. Creates a storm lead, presidential debate. Humanoid androids, reptilian race. For control of the United States, Watergate. Their subjected state into industrial waste. Planet of the apes, memory erased. Identity stole, given to a Vatican more. World as a whore, watch my inner poor. World peace, given the mark of the beast. Private property cease, and new knockers and lower leaves. Carries a contagious disease. The truth has set me free from a way to use society. I seen a sheep that looked like it was a shepherd. I told them, can it be all so simple then? I told them, what the fuck? Can I put my fucking dick on your nipple then? Okay, maybe you go. When we came to LA, it was all seven. I went to heaven with those seven of them.
So I bring it back. I'm taking the stacks. Check how it is that I roll up in your block. And you know that I'm racking, I'm taking it. I don't give a fuck, I don't asking it. Check how it is that I'm rolling with the plastic around it and the fucking yellow tape. Damn indeed, you know that I escape off the fucking cut of the neck. What's next? Damn it, I dialect. What's motherfucking? How it is that I got respect
on the top of the spot. Cause you know that I don't give a fuck about it. Check how it is, damn it indeed. You know that I knotted it up. Like motherfuckers getting fucked up in the fight. So damn it, you know we all up. And you know it's all night. Cause call me when I'm fighting. Check it out, I'm Tyson. Every time I'm inspiring the right and I'm a writing. So check how it is that we break down your door. Hey, I'm breaking in the window. You want, you want more. So check it out, damn. Indeed, you know we got it up. Check out with this. Motherfuckers talk shit. You get knotted up. You get fucked up. So I run up. On your spot, we got guns up. And we blaze it up. So what up? I'm fucking raising up. Like, hey, a razor. It was from the homie crew. So check it out. What the fuck you wanna do? It's C1. You know where I'm coming from. I'll fuck up your crew and your fucking dynasty. It's C1. Ain't no refining me. Cause damn it, indeed. I break it up like fine china when I be fucking off the top of the line.
I'm gonna say it this one time, rest in peace, prodigy. Eight heads in a duffel bag, 44 caliber man. Over biological weapon slam, zigzag, over house in Japan. You feel the razor blade slice with the ice cream stab. Now the butter covers a lobster, lemon spritz on the crab. Left hook follows two right jabs. That's bloody rounds, that made them throw in the towel. The money laundered in the cost to make the cop put a sound. Thrown in the barrio, surrounded by the scenario. With double fisted troops and cities and killing audios. I'm hacking off phantom limbs, barbaric bloodshed beams. Heads fall down the set, these one is human for beams. Never suit me the skin, sipping soup from the shark skin. Power within, I said go ahead, without a minute, baby Bible. It's a thousand disciple, it's a book of the ice. And I'm at the top of the ice with a rifle. Heaven is kept. I'm about to go suicidal. I slice my own neck if you disrespect. Twisted tech, contra, shit out to disciple. You better go ahead. Basic instructions before leaving Earth. That's the acronym of the Bible. So go ahead, we out for survival. Just last night, my power turned off. And all we do, we didn't give a fuck. We took some skin off. We told them, guess what? This bomb is going off. What happened when we tried to get here today? The motherfuckers blocked off the 71 freeway. We hit a corner. We put right around the sequence. Wouldn't give a fuck. Go ahead and beat the quickness. We left them right by the garbage can. And guess what? The couch was laying by the gutter. Next thing you know, the acid is fucking sweating.
That's right, we gotta go tip it up. We do this
we
thing every Monday night, man.
We gotta go tip it
thank
up.
Thank you guys for tuning in.
The B-side, you know that's the
side. Let's get a couple more clicks before we go. Tune in next week. And tomorrow night, Bill the Wonder live at Katie Jake's. Make sure you guys go check us out. Party with us. Super Drew, thank you, dog. Hey, Shay Whitey, Joseph Cass, thank you for being part of our crew, man. Big G, Drac, Shay Whitey, Lehigh, man, my homie Daryl, man, that's what's up. B-Side Show, we're out. We'll see you next week. Peace.
What's up, CJ Cuber? You listening to Super